Hi, this is Jose Luis, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to write a simple, very lean WebSocket server in C# using a console application. And I'm also going to show you how to connect that to all the previous clients and all the previous applications that we have done in the previous videos on this playlist, Fun with WebSockets. So as usual, we're going to start by simply starting a new Visual Studio project. And I'm going to create a new project, and it's going to be a console application on the .NET framework. So it's going to be this one, .NET framework. I'm going to put it on my desktop, and I'm going to call it C# server. Okay. And it's going to be on the .NET framework 4.5, blah, blah, blah. And as I create this project, you can see that now I have this folder on my server that is on my desktop, which is the server, and I can start writing code here. As we saw on the previous video, I'm going to import the WebSocket library. So I'm going to browse here, and I'm going to type WebSocket Sharp, and I'm going to select this one, which I believe is the original one by the author of the project. So I'm going to install this dependency. And then now in my code, I can just import that dependency by typing using WebSocket Sharp. Okay. All right. The next thing that I'm going to do is that because I'm writing a server, I actually need to import another namespace, which contains code specifically for WebSocket server stuff. So that's going to be within the same library, WebSocket Sharp. You can see that I have a server namespace that I'm going to need to import here. Okay, wonderful. All right, so what is next? The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to initialize this server. So the way we're going to do this is by creating a WebSocket server instance. So I'm going to do WebSocket server, and WebSocket server is going to create a new variable, and I'm going to initialize this WebSocket server with the URL where this is going to be living. Because this server is going to be living on my machine, I don't need to give it a name or a domain. What I need to do is I need to specify that the server is going to be the machine that this code is going to be living on. The way I do that is by typing localhost, which is the nickname that we typically use for referring to the machine where we live in. Or alternatively, I could just type 127.0.0.1, which is the IP that is reserved always for localhost for the same machine where you're living on. All right. And now the second thing that we want to do is I would like to assign a port. Because it's going to be living on a machine, machines have different ports which point to different processes living on that machine. So I can just, technically what I should do is I should use a port manager to check which ports on my local machine are open or closed and are busy with other processes. But I know that if I type a random number, there's a very high chance that I'm not going to hit a port that is being used. And if I do, I will get an error. So it's not a big deal. So I'm just going to choose 7, 8, 9, and 0. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to start this server, and I'm going to type some message here, console write line, server started on, this address here. All right. Just for the sake of having some feedback. And then to make sure that this program stays alive, because it's a console application, so we're going to do as we typically do, the trick of just requesting a key before we stop the server. All right. Sorry, stop. Oh, what am I doing? Yes, stop. So whenever the user presses any key, then we will stop the server and we will shut down the console application. So let's start this. If I start this, and I'm going to make sure that this window shows up always on the screen, you can see that the WebSocket server has started and it's on this address, blah, blah, blah. So I wonder if I can use my previous code now to connect to this server already. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this address, all right? and I'm going to replace. So what am I doing? So I'm going to replace that with my address here, which it was in my client, and it was this one here. All right. So I'm going to try to connect to this server, and turns out that the WebSocket server that I specified is not really working. It's not really working because I have not really created any service on my WebSocket server to handle incoming connections. What does that mean? What it means is that when you have a server, you have to create some kind of route, or you have to create some kind of place where clients can go, and then where different functionality of different behavior is served for those clients. So remember, in previous examples, we were doing an echo server that took information and then just sent that same information back to the server, to the client. So in C# and with the WebSocket Sharp library, we have to do something like that. And the way we do that is by extending and subclassing a very particular class that lives in WebSocket Sharp called the WebSocket Server Behavior. Okay? That is a little confusing, perhaps, maybe at the beginning. So let me show you how that is done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to write a new public class that is going to be called, for example, Echo. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that I am extending, I'm using as the template, I'm extending a WebSocket behavior class that comes with this library. So when someone, whoever the author of this library was, what they did was they created this template that you can use to create your own implementations of a behavior for the WebSocket server. What does that mean? What it means is now that we have the WebSocket behavior, what I can do is I can override, and you can see I can override certain functions that come with the class. So for example, on close, on error, on message, on open, and this may ring a bell because when we saw the client, we saw that we had the event handlers that look very similar, on close, on error, on message. So these are basically a way of doing event handling, which is whenever I receive a message from the client, what I want to do is whatever I want to do here. And what I want to do probably is that I want to send, I'm going to write to the console, for example, console write line received message from client. Okay. And then I'm going to print I'm going to print e.data. And then what I want to do is I want to send back to the client the same message. So that's going to be send dot open parenthesis e dot data. Okay. Are we all here? Does that make sense? All right. So I think this behavior should work already. But now what we need to do is we need to make sure that this WebSocket server has that behavior somewhere attached to it. The way we're going to do that is we're going to say, we're going to use a slightly esoteric or strange syntax that comes with the library, which is to the WebSocket server, we're going to add a WebSocket service. All right. And you can see that as I was auto-completing, you see that I have the angle bracket notations. What that means is that it needs a type to know what kind of service to attach to this server. What I'm going to do is I'm going to attach the Echo class, which is the one that has the code that knows how to run and how to handle the behavior of that server. And then I'm going to open and close parentheses. And inside the parentheses, I'm going to add an extension to the route or to the host of the WebSocket server, so that that particular route is the one that has the particular echo behavior. All right. So let me show how that works. I'm going to open and close double quotes, and I'm going to add a route with a forward slash that I'm going to call echo. What that means is that any client that goes to this URL plus this route afterwards will hit a WebSocket server that has an echo behavior. Okay, does that make sense? So I'm going to actually copy this here just for clarity, and then I'm going to run this server. Okay, WebSocket server started on this route. So I'm going to copy this route, actually. Oops, sorry, I closed the server. I'm going to copy this route, and I'm going to bring it back to my client. So I'm going to, here in my client, remember when we switch from the cloud server, we switch to the local one. So now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add an echo. This is going to be the route. And I'm going to start this code. And what I'm going, you can see that as I do, if I minimize here, the server did receive a message from the client, hello from PCAMP. And then the client received the echo message from the server back. So hello from PCAMP, and then it didn't know what to do because we were doing JSON parsing and geometry, etc., etc. Does this make sense? Uh-huh. So the pattern, this is what I believe it's typically is technically referred to, the pattern that the WebSocket Sharp library offers for creating servers is customizing behavior by extending the WebSocket behavior class and then attaching those behaviors to the server under a particular route, which is very interesting because it also means that we can add several behaviors to the same WebSocket server, which only differ in how do we access them. So for example, the code that I've written here is great, but it doesn't really do what we've done in the other examples, which is echoing one message to all the clients that are connected to the server. This server would only echo to the one client that is connected to the server. And we can see that behavior if, for example, we have here the server. No, this is the client. So I'm going to stop the client. We have the server, right? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my client folder. And in the client folder, because I have executed, I have compiled in the code in debug, you can see that I actually have an application that I can double click, which is the C# client. So you see, I double click on this, I open a client, I get the server back and forth. But if I open a second one, you see, this one also gets the echo from the server, but the other client did not receive that message from the second client. And if I open a third one, none of the first or the second ones get the message broadcasted from the server. So right now it's working on a one-to-one basis. And what we want to do is we want to work on a one-to-many basis. So how are we going to do that? We're going to create another behavior that is going to be called echo to all. So I'm going to public class echo all, and I'm going to extend WebSocket behavior. All right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this here, and then I'm going to blah, 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 received message from echo client, received message from echo all client, right? And what I'm going to do here now, instead of sending the data, the way we do this with this library, with the WebSocket Sharp library, is just by accessing the sessions property of the library, and then just saying using broadcast. Do we have broadcast? Yes, broadcast, which is send a message to everyone that is connected to this server. And that's going to be e.data. So let's see if this works. I'm going to execute this code. This is the server. And now in my client, I need to change from echo to echo all. So I'm going to connect now. Oops. And the current state of the connection is not open. Ooh, what is going on here? Let me take a look at what's going on. Oh yeah, silly mistake. Remember on the server, we did create the behavior, but we forgot to attach that behavior to the server. So I'm going to copy this. I'm going to attach another service. This is going to be echo for all. All right. And on this route here. And then I'm also, just for the sake of clarity, I'm going to write line to the console that we have two servers, two services running on the same server. So now I'm going to execute this code. We have the server that has both behaviors. I'm going to minimize that. And then I have here echo all, which I've already executed once, so it is compiled. So we can now go to my C# client, the application that gets compiled in the background, and then I can execute this one. And then you can see that I receive a message from the echo all client, and I'm going to click for a second time. And you can see that this one received, but this, the second client also received a message. And if I do it a third time, you can see that as I connect, the other two clients also receive notifications of this echo. Okay. So, all right. So that was it. And then now if we extended this more, we could just connect them and we could exchange JSON information, coordinates, and draw the ASCII box, et cetera, et cetera. But I'm actually going to leave that up as an exercise for you, the viewer, for give you an opportunity to have your own fun as well with this. Okay. All right, great. So I hope this was helpful for you. And thank you very much for watching these videos. Please consider liking them, subscribing to the channel, etc., etc. And let's move on to the next videos in the series and keep finding new ways of connecting different things together and having some fun with WebSockets. Bye.